Hello, viewer. Welcome to Sun's Up. I am Nicholas Kipkoech, a former student from the Connerbrook School. We are going to learn a topic in Form 1 about the divisibility test. Please. First, what is a divisibility test? A divisibility test is a practical. It's a practical number to test or to identify whether a number is divisible by a certain number. And first, the main areas you are going to see is the divisibility for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, and 11. First, let's see the divisibility for 2. Divisibility test for 2. How can you know that a number is divisible by 2? Then, a number is divisible by 2. If the last digit is 0 or an even number. And what is an even number? An even number is a number that is divisible by 2 without the remainder. Therefore, as we had said, a number is divisible by 2 if the last digit is 0 or an even number. For example, you can be given a number like 334 and be asked to test whether that number is divisible by 2. And since the last digit is 4, surely, since we know 4 is an even number, that number is obviously divisible by 2. Another example is 410. We had said the last digit is 0 or an even number. This one, the last digit is 0. That sign tells us obviously that number is divisible by 2. And from then, we are going to see the divisibility test for 3. Also, how can you... Divisibility test for 3. How can you know that a number is divisible by 3? A number is divisible by 3 if the sum of its digits is divisible by 3. And I mean, if you have been given a number like 27, to know that this 27, to test whether this 27 is divisible by 3, you add 2 plus 7. You get 9. And 9 is divisible by 3. The whole of this number now shows that that number is divisible by 3. Another example. If you have been given a number like 10, 32, 402, and 1,000,000. 32,402. To test whether that number is divisible by 3, you add 2, 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, plus 3 is 4, plus 2 is 6, plus 4 is 10, plus 0 is 10, plus 2 is 12. You add the whole digits in that number. 12 is obviously divisible by 3. The whole of this number shows that that number is divisible by 3. Then we are going to the divisibility test for 4. Again, how can you know that a number is divisible by 4? A number is divisible by 4 if the last two digits is either 00 or forms a number that is divisible by 4. For example, you might be given a number like this example, 791,300. You look for the last two digits. The last two digits here is 00. And we had said, if the 004 forms a number that is divisible by 4. Obviously, the whole of this number now is divisible by 4. Another example is like this, 7,672. You look for the last two digits. The last two digits here form 72. And 72 is divisible by 4. And this one identifies or shows that the whole of this number also is divisible by 4. And another example here is 303,016. You look for also for the last two digits, and the last two digits here is 16. This 16 tells us, since it is divisible by 4, it tells us that the whole of this number is divisible by 4. And you might be given also a number like 21,443. You also look for the last two digits. 43. Is 43 divisible by 4? No.
This number now
tells us that 21,443 is not divisible by 4. Why?
Because the last two digits forms a number that is not divisible by 4. So to 5,111.
This number,
to test whether it is divisible by 4,
also look for the last two digits.
The last two digits here
is 11. 11 is not divisible by 4.
And this shows that
the whole of this number is not divisible by 4.
And that makes us to move to the divisibility test for 5. Divisibility test for 5.
Again, you might be asked to test whether a certain number is divisible by 5. How can you know that a number is divisible by 5? A number is divisible by 5 if the last digit is 0 or 5.
For example,
you might be given a large number like
2410
and you can be asked to test whether this number is divisible by 5.
We look for the last digit, which is 0. The last digit is 0. And we are saying,
the last digit, if it is 0 or 5.
And this number
has the last digit as 0.
This shows that the whole of this number is divisible by 5.
And another number you might be given like
312,625.
You look for the last digit. The last digit here is 5.
And 5 is
among the identification of the divisible for 5.
This shows that the whole of this number, 312,625,
is divisible by 5.
And also a number might be given, that 1,413.
You look for the last digit, if it is either 0 or 5.
And since it is 3, this number tells us that
1,413 is not divisible by 5, since the last digit is not 0 or 5.
And that makes us to move to the divisibility test for 6.
How can you know that a number is divisible by 6? A number is divisible by 6 if that number is divisible by both 2 and 3.
And we are discussing about the divisibility test for 2 and 3.
For example, you might be given a number
like 144
and be asked to test whether that number is divisible by 6. You apply two methods.
You test whether this number is divisible by 2 and 3.
That is, for 2, you look if the last digit is 0 or an even number.
And to tell us that the last digit here is 4.
4 is an even number. That shows that
144 is divisible by 2.
Then another method is, you test whether this number is divisible by 3.
You add all digits in this number. 1 plus 4 plus 4, which you get 9.
9 is divisible by 3.
And this tells us that 144 is divisible by 3.
And we had said earlier, 144 is divisible by 2, since the last digit is even number.
This tells us that the whole of this number
is divisible by 6, since it is divisible by both 2 and 3. Another example is, you might be given
1,716.
And you'll be asked to test whether this number is divisible by 6. You look if it is divisible by both 2 and 6. And we begin with 2.
This number is divisible by 2, since the last digit is 6, which is an even number.
And to test whether it is divisible by 3,
we add 7 plus 1 is 8, plus 1 is 9, plus 6 is 15.
15 is divisible by 3.
And this shows that the whole of this number is now divisible by 6, since it is divisible by both 2 and 3.
Then, let's move to the divisibility test for 8. How can you know that a number is divisible by 8?
Divisibility test for 8. To test whether a number is divisible by 8, You look for the last three digits. If it is 000, if it is 000, or forms a number that is divisible by 8. For example, 534,000. To test whether that number is divisible by 8, you look for the last three digits. If it is 000, or forms a number that is divisible by 8. And since it is 000, that number is divisible by 8. And another example is
562,960.
You look for the last three digits. Since it is not 000, test that number if it is divisible by 8.
If you divide 960
by 8, it is possible. And this shows that 562,000 is divisible by 562,960 is divisible by 6. That makes us to move into the divisibility test for 9. How can you know that a number is divisible by 9? In that method, you use the applications or principles for the divisibility test for 3. To test whether a number is divisible by 9, you add all digits, or in other words, a number is divisible by 9 if the sum of its digits is divisible by 9. For example, you might be given a number like 27. To test whether that number is divisible by 9, you add 2 plus 7, which forms 9, and 9 is divisible by 9. This shows that 27 is divisible by 9. Another number is 103,722. To test whether that number is divisible by 9, you add all digits, which is 1 plus 3 is 4, plus 3 is 7, plus 7 is 14, 14 plus 4 is 18. The root of this number is divisible by 8, by 9, since the number formed by the sum of its digits is divisible by 9. Then divisibility, that makes us to move into the divisibility test for 10. And before, if you add these digits and forms a number that is not divisible by 9, sure, obviously that number is not divisible by 9, since it forms a number that cannot be divided by 9. Let's move to the divisibility test for 10. A number is divisible by 10 only if the last digit is 0. For example, 100. 100 is divisible by 10 since the last digit is 0. Or 50. Test whether 50 is divisible by 10. 50 is divisible by 10 since or because the last digit is 0. What of 43? 43 is not divisible by 10 since the last digit is 3, not 0. And let's move to the divisibility test for 11. Divisibility test for 11. How can you know that a number is divisible by 11? A number is divisible by 11 if the difference between the sum of its digits in alternating position is 0 or 11 or any multiple of 11. For example, you might be given a number like 14,355. Since we had said if the difference between the digits in alternating positions can be 0 or 11 or any multiple of 11, let's add in alternating position here is 1 to 3 and 3 to 5. If you add 1 plus 3 is 4, plus 5, which is 9, you sum 9. Another alternative is 4 to 5. If you add 4 plus 5, you get 9. See, and then subtract now. 9 minus 9 is 0. That number is divisible by 11 since the difference in the intercept of the digits in alternating position is 0. Another number is m
97,812.
Sum the alternating digits.
9 plus 8 is 17, plus 2 is 19. 7 plus 1 is 8. You subtract 19 minus 8 is 11.
That number is divisible by 11, since the difference between the sum of the alternating digits is 11. Then lastly, let's test if
number like 30, 57, 642,
if it is divisible by 9, if it is divisible by 11,
and let's add the alternating digits. 5 plus 1 is 6, plus 6 is 12, plus 2 is 14. Then 3 plus 7 is 10, plus 4 is 14. The difference is 14 minus 14, which is 0.
The whole of this number is now divisible by 11, since the difference between the alternating digits is 0. Up to then, we have come to the end of our lesson. Keep it a little TV, where you watch and learn. Thank you.